Welcome to another episode of Let's Play Conversations here at Entertainment Burrito. Today's topic, the Final Fantasy Uncovered event. Beautiful. It's uncovered. Undressed.
Just sexy. How I like it.
I know. So, a lot of things happened.
Yeah, a lot of things.
A lot of things. It was a good event overall. But
me too, I agree. I thought Greg and Tim did a really good job.
Yeah. It was good. I know some people were calling them man babies. Like, oh my God, these guys are being excited about it. But yeah, it is an exciting thing.
But that's how they are on their podcast.
Right. So. No, I think they're usually a little more chilled than that. But no, it was good overall. I had no problem with it. I thought they made it entertaining.
Yeah, I agree.
So, haters gonna hate, right?
Yeah.
Whatever. So let's go in order of things they did, right? So
right
in the beginning, they said okay, we have 14 announcements. It eventually became 15 with an extended.
Yeah, because it's Final Fantasy 15, I would guess.
Yeah. So it was why 14 announcements? Just say one fucking thing.
Yeah, just make something up.
Say this guy has hair.
This guy's hair. 15th.
No, but okay, the first thing that happened was the creator of Final Fantasy. He came out, Mr. Sakaguchi.
Mm-hmm.
And he hasn't made a Final Fantasy in a very long time. The last one he was really involved with was, I'm probably wrong, but 7 and 8. Mm-hmm. I think those were the last ones he was involved with. He didn't direct it, but he was producing it, I'm pretty sure. So those were the last ones he was involved with. But after that, he went on to do his own thing.
I mean, did they announce that he's somewhat a part of it, or they just brought him out?
No, they brought him out because he's saying, hey, look, I'm here just like you guys. I'm a fan. And I'm excited with all the stuff that's happening. And I'm just here to say, hey, this stuff looks good. He almost a spokesperson. I wouldn't say spokesperson, but he's just a fan.
Yeah.
Coming out and saying, this stuff is great, guys. And I'm going to be in the front seat with you guys watching this. And I'm going to be enjoying it. So that's what he was there for. It was nice seeing him. Last time we saw him was GDC last year when he accepted an award. And that was pretty cool. Okay, let's go to number 2.
Yeah, they announced a new, they showed a new trailer.
They showed, a trailer that eventually would have been shown in an extended.
Yeah.
But this trailer showed a little more story stuff, a lot of gameplay. We've known more of the story in the last 3-4 months because they have a lot of their reports.
Yeah.
Have explained it, but this time it was in a lot of cutscenes, a lot of gameplay. So that had a lot of cool stuff. In that trailer, they had a brand new song in it.
Which is Stand By Me. It's a really classic song.
That's a classic.
I enjoyed the cover of it. I thought it was a really good cover.
I really did Florence and the Machine,
Yeah, Florence and the Machine. That was announcement number 3 that they made.
Right. Four. Yeah. It was 4. We skipped 1, but fuck it. It doesn't matter.
We don't give a shit.
We don't know how to count.
We don't know.
But let's talk about 4 anyway, since we're talking about the song.
Yeah.
It says Florence Welch of Florence and the Machine.
Yes.
Is that the whole title? Or no, her name is Florence Welch.
And she's part of Florence the Machine.
Okay, just making sure.
Florence Welch
of Florence and the Machine.
I've heard. I'm pretty sure the band name is.
Her name is Florence Welch.
No.
And she's a machine.
No, that's a plot for Terminator 6 or whatever.
Genesis Florence.
The Terminator Florence.
Revenge of Florence.
Florence.
Okay.
Yes, you could say that.
Okay, so. Confirmed her name.
Confirmed, yes. Confirmed. Thank you. This is the breaking stuff you come to us for.
Breaking shit. Okay.
Florence
so,
the Machine.
Revenge of Florence, anyways. She did a good job.
Yeah, it was really
her
good.
And her band did a good job.
And her
machines.
And her
the machines.
Her orchestra.
Her orchestra. Yeah, I like that. I always enjoy seeing the orchestra stuff.
Me too. Yeah, for sure.
I guess
sure.
Working
hands
in
down.
Music, we kind of see
sure.
A lot.
Hands
so.
Down.
But that was really cool stuff.
I thought having that as the song or the title track.
Yeah, well, that's one of the
main
major
music
songs
or whatever.
Yeah,
I thought it was really good.
Yeah, and it's a classic song. She sung it really well. I'm happy with it.
Me too.
Okay, so going to number 3, back to number 3,
yeah.
Was pretty much the artwork by Yoshitaru Amano, one of the best Final Fantasy artists.
Yeah, it looked really good. I liked it. I thought it was really, really...
It was beautiful, and I like that trailer they did, going inside the picture, actually, and, seeing... I think those were the gods or the summons that you use in the actual game, so... Yeah, because it is they are pretty much gods in that universe. So actually going in and seeing the artwork and seeing how beautiful it was, really good stuff. So not much more to talk about that because it was just simple.
Yeah.
Let's go to number five. More gameplay was shown.
Yes. And we have Chocobo Drifting now.
Fast and Furious Final Fantasy. FFFF. A tie-in.
Final Fantasy Chocobo.
Final Fantasy Furious Chocobos.
Furious Chocobos. I like that.
Can't wait for that game. And it was good stuff seeing all that. During that part where, well, it's because like he's on the chocobos, but then he gets off and he does some battling.
Yeah.
And then in the back, you see a Titan just fucking running. That was cool. That was awesome because that looked like that had to be in game. You know, before it became a cutscene at least. Oh, yeah. But the cutscene was still in game. But just the fact that you see this giant fucking man running and sprinting.
Oh yeah, I thought it was over. Completely well done.
Yeah, and then I mean, you saw the guy in the trailer. That was the point number two. Mm-hmm. But like him picking the group up and then using his technique, Gaia's Wrath. I thought that was really cool.
Yeah, and you just saw all the basically fighting mechanics, and it looks like fun.
Yeah, this is pretty much the perfected one, not the one that we saw in that demo last year. Yeah, this is pretty much the final version of the battle system. And you play a little bit in the new demo that came out, which we'll talk about soon. So, going to number six, The World of Wonder. They did this before, but it's basically videos about the environment.
And I thought it looked very beautiful.
Yeah,
like, I'm not a huge Final Fantasy fan. Like, I just played 10. Mm-hmm. And like seeing all this, like how beautiful the game is, you know.
It's a whole world.
The story of brotherhood and stuff like that. I'm like, I'm pretty excited for this.
Yeah, like getting onto that. Yeah, that's right. 10 was the only one, right?
Yeah, 10 was the only one I actually like really, really played.
Right. And you beat that one, actually.
I haven't beat the HD, but I beat it on PS2.
Yeah.
And, or whatever it was.
And you liked it, right?
Oh, I liked it. Yeah, it was fucking awesome.
Good. So this is going to be much better than that, I promise you.
Hopefully it is.
Because most people think 10 was the weakest point of the series, but I like 10.
Really?
Yeah, most people think it was one of the... It was the beginning of the end.
Many well, 10, well, 10 too was bad.
10 2 was just fucking funny. I didn't hate 10 2 like a lot of people hated. I just took it as it was. It's a fucking joke.
Yeah, but they fucking changed the whole battle system up. Yeah, that's why I didn't like it.
But they do that for every Final Fantasy.
If it has 10, like, sequel to
that
10...
That doesn't matter. They don't give a fuck.
It's completely from a turn base to a fucking... I don't know what the fuck it was.
Right. But we got off track, yeah, as usual.
Oh, man, no worries.
You should play 7 Remake, though. That would be fucking the best thing ever.
No, I will.
If it ever comes out.
When trophies come out. I get it.
Trophies. Anyways. So, yeah. It's another environment thing. Showing this world, you know.
Yeah, which looks beautiful.
Showing the creatures, whatever. Beautiful stuff. They did this before. They did it now. It's nice. It's still nice. Okay. Number 7. Let's see. A 5-part anime series.
Yeah.
First episode's already out.
Yes. Yeah. And you watched it. I haven't had a chance to watch it.
I watched it.
How is it?
It's 11 minutes. But it's 11 good minutes.
It's really?
It's really good. It's these episodes are basically prequels and origins to the characters. You know, mainly to the four people in your group. The prince, the Noctis, and then your three guys. So this one was it wasn't focusing on anybody in particular, but I guess in the beginning you see an event that the main character had, you know, Noctis, that a death of somebody, and he almost died. So you see some battling in the anime, and it looked really good.
Really?
So yeah, it looked really good. So I reckon it's 11 minutes. So
where'd you watch it? Just online?
It's on YouTube. It's on their official channel.
It's on YouTube?
Yeah, it's on Final Fantasy 15 YouTube channel, whatever.
Okay.
So it's there. It's pretty much available everywhere. So nobody has an excuse not to at least check it out, because it is good stuff. It is canon stuff to the story. Mm-hmm. So enjoy that. All right.
Yeah, what's number 8?
Number 8.
In the term of new releases, they announced a full CG movie.
Full CG movie. They haven't made one since Advent Children.
I don't remember.
Which was a Final Fantasy VII's sequel, if you will. And that was a really good movie. Good stuff. Mm. So I expect this to be the same thing.
That's a good cast. They announced Aaron Paul, Lena... What's her name?
Lena...
Hardy? Haiti?
Headley.
That's right.
Headley. That was a guest, too.
That was a guest. Had Aaron and Lena there.
And Sean Bean. That's the most relevant one, in my opinion. You know? That guy, I wonder if he's going to die in this one. Because he's a fan of dying in all his roles. You know?
That's true.
That's a terrible joke.
They also announced the special edition Audi. R8 they're gonna make one of.
They're only gonna make one.
Run of one.
They're gonna make one. I don't know why this was an announcement, but it's like, hey, we're making one car.
It probably was that they needed one more announcement because they were at 14. Yeah. And like, fuck it, let's make the car.
It might have been that. Might have been the one. But anyways, it's a nice looking car. That's it, I guess. And they're only making one. Maybe they're gonna give it away. I think they almost kind of hinted that it was gonna be
like auctioned off,
auctioned or something, or maybe a contest.
Probably. Well, with the 10 we talked about already, about the cast of everybody.
Right. We already said all the cast.
Yeah.
The movie looks cool. By the way, the movie's in during the game.
Yeah.
So it actually takes part, and the movie comes with the collector's edition. I think it's also going to be free to download. So everybody's going to be able to see it. Okay, number 11 is a mini game in the game, but also we're receiving it through our smartphones.
Yeah, just like Blitzball, but on our phones.
Yeah.
And like, but it seemed kind of weird to me because it seemed like an arcade game, but not like really like.
It was like a pinball.
A pinball, but with monsters or something like that. It's still a little weird for me to look at.
I don't know. Like the pinball games that I've seen, the very rare times I've seen pinball machines lately, they've been kind of updated like crazy, you know? So I guess this is kind of like just an answer to that. So it might be the same thing. I don't know. We'll see. But I guess I'll give the game a try.
Me too.
It'll be on Android soon.
If it's free, why
it
not?
It is free. So why not? Justice Monsters 5.
Yeah.
All right. Number 12.
The demo they announced.
The Platinum demo.
Platinum demo.
Second demo they came out with.
I downloaded the demo. I haven't played it yet. You beat it. What do you think of it?
I beat it. I should say you're basically in a dream. And it's as when you were a kid, the main character as a kid. So you're just going through a dream. It's not part of the game itself. It's just, you know, outside of it. And you're just going through. It's very Kingdom Hearts-esque in terms of, well, the gameplay was, you know, similar. But just even the weapons you use and then the little things. But, it's fun. It's fun, especially in the end. It's not a spoiler, really, because it's a fucking 20-minute demo. But in the end, you play as, you know, him grown up. As you will play in the full game, and then you actually fight one boss, and that's a really cool moment because you know right there and then that's the final battle system. This is how it's gonna play. So if you never played the demo last year, then you have an idea.
I never played the demo.
So there you go.
But you're with your buddy Carbuncle.
Carbuncle, yes. Carbuncle. Who you could name, and then that name will transfer to the real game.
Oh, that's pretty cool.
Yeah. So I know where you're gonna name it after your fucking dog.
All right, then after that, they got some collector's editions that they announced. Right. Deluxe edition and a collector's edition.
Two collector's editions, right. Two fucking editions. So one's $80, comes with a steel bookcase thingy. Steel case, I shouldn't say bookcase. Steel case. Comes with DLC, stuff like that. And the movie. The ultimate collector's edition, that's a fucking...
Yeah.
I know people are saying like that's crazy priced, but it's like...
Look, how much was it?
It's like $260.
Oh, Sean, fuck that.
Yeah,
I'm not getting that.
Yeah, no, I'm a fucking idiot, and I got it.
Oh, you got it?
I pre-ordered it. I might cancel it later, but I wanted just to get it just in case.
Hmm.
But like the things it comes with, it's like a full-on figure, which is worth over $100. Player Arts Kai figures are usually worth, you know, that or more.
And it's only like I think 30,000. He said
there's 30,000, so it's very exclusive. Mm-hmm. And then the art book, which is it's 200-page art book, pretty much. It's like 180 exactly, mm-hmm. but you know. So those things together are pretty much $200, plus the game, plus all the DLC, and then the steel case,
and the movie, and soundtracks.
It's like, yeah, I could see how it's $260. I could easily see how it's $260. So I'm not going to bitch about it, but will I go through with it? Maybe
like,
not.
I haven't really been buying collector's editions.
I haven't in... Last one I bought was the Metal Gear one, because I'm a big Metal Gear guy.
I think last one I bought was Uncharted 3. That was the last one I bought.
I could have sworn you bought something else.
No.
Yeah, Batman?
No, the Batman. I had the Joker there, but no, that was Batman. It was because I came out after. Because
right, yeah, there hasn't been too many good collectors.
Because I was Arkham Origins, and I liked the Joker.
That's right, right.
It was Arkham. I don't know. It was one of them.
Doesn't fucking matter. There hasn't been too many good ones, but like I like what this one is giving. Mm-hmm. This one is actually giving good shit. So it's just a little expensive, but I don't fucking care. Anywho,
and number 14.
Number 14. The actual release date.
Yeah, they teased it, like they put November 30th, well, and then it jumped down to September.
We knew that day.
Yeah, from like a leak.
From GameSpot, which I'm sure they're gonna enjoy getting sued.
No, it was funny, like how they first, like, Greg and Tim went to it. It's like, don't touch the button. You'll announce the release date. And it's like, GameStop already touched the button. I'm like, no, that's funny.
Yeah, so that kind of fucking sucked for them. You know, that was a big moment and it got ruined.
Yeah.
But, you know, it is what it is. Everybody's happy, though, because it's relatively soon, September 30th.
Yeah, and then we have the last one where they showed more of the trailer and delved deeper into the story. And
the extended cut of the trailer.
Yeah, I'm going to have fun with it. I think I'm
really... Yeah, that trailer was really good. Like, it was good on an emotional level. Like, you know, the stuff with him and his father, it was really cool. So I'm really excited for it.
Me too. I can't wait.
I can't wait for this shit. And it's only a few months away, so.
Yeah, I can't wait.
All good stuff. So that's pretty much it. You know, 15 things to like. Like it, hate it, fuck you.
Whatever. Take care. Bye-bye.
Goodbye.
Shit. Oh, boom, 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 boom.
Oh, shit.
So as you'll see, our next Let's Play conversation here is some Uncharted.
The beta, which was...